Well, more has been written and debated about this next work than almost any other 20th century piece of music. Shostakovich wrote this Fifth Symphony in 1937 at the height of Stalin's purges. It was a time of arrests in the middle of the night, of show trials, gulags and executions. Shostakovich's life, not just his career, was on a knife edge after his previous work, the opera Lady Macbeth of Mtsensk, had been considered too modern, too complex to be properly communist. Members of his family disappeared. His mentor in the party was shot. And yet how to play safe and retain artistic credibility? Well, it would be nearly 2 years before he presented a new major work. And when he did, it was with a note of contrition. His Fifth Symphony was accompanied by an article entitled A Soviet Artist's Creative Response to Just Criticism. Whether Shostakovich had a hand in writing these words or simply allowed them to be published under his name is unknown. Well, the Fifth Symphony was a critical, political, and public success. The music is unsettling, it's sensitive, it's conflicted. There are nods to Russian Orthodox requiems, there are nods to other great Russian composers, and therefore it is open to any number of interpretations. Should the symphony be taken at face value, a loyal Soviet artist, or is there a hidden note of subversion in the music? Well, let's listen and you can decide.
And here is Philippe Jourdan to conduct the Gustav Mahler Youth Orchestra in Shostakovich's Fifth Symphony.
Thank you.
Just listen to that roar for the Gustav Mahler Youth Orchestra's performance of Shostakovich's Fifth Symphony. They played with the energy and the intensity and focus that we have come to expect from this exceptional youth orchestra, conducted tonight by Philippe Jourdan. The first performance of the Fifth Symphony was given in 1937 by the Leningrad Philharmonic Orchestra in Leningrad. The audience were on their feet even before the end of that performance. Not everyone so confident, though. There's a tale of conductor Kurt Sanderling, who listened to the piece a year later, height of Stalin's purges. It was being performed in Moscow, and he remembers that after the first movement, they all looked around rather nervously, wondering whether we might be arrested after the concert. There's our friend Yulia, the leader of the Gustav Mahler Youth Orchestra, concertmaster, I should call her, official title, being brought to her feet and thanked by Philippe there. An inspiring group of young musicians on the stage at the Royal Albert Hall. Some of the finest musicians in Europe already. Many of them will go on to have illustrious careers. So remember their faces. Philippe Jourdan bringing the soloists to their feet. He himself is such a star of the young generation of conductors. He's the musical director of the Opéra National de Paris, and he's going to become chief conductor of the Vienna Symphony Orchestra next year. Cheers continue to ring around the Royal Albert Hall. That is all from us here tonight. But if you would like to hear tonight's concert again, it is available on the BBC iPlayer. On the BBC Proms website, you can catch highlights of the whole season. And don't forget, you can listen to all the Proms live on Radio 3. Do join me tomorrow evening at 7:30 on BBC 4. We have a glittering red carpet event here at the Royal Albert Hall when John Wilson and his orchestra return to the Proms with Hollywood Rhapsody. But tonight, from me, Katie Derham, goodbye.